In just a moment, we're going to be talking to David Ray Griffin, best-selling author, 35 books on philosophy, religion, politics. He's had a lot of great books, but New Pearl Harbor Revisited was a Publisher's Week pick of the week. And we're going to get his response on all the new big 9/11 developments. And does he think that the establishment's going to have to stage some new terror to get control? Jundullah, it's admitted, over in Iran, is an al-Qaeda offshoot, formerly commanded by the number three in al-Qaeda. Bush admitted they were funding them to stage terror attacks inside Iran. They just blew up a military base headquarters, killed a bunch of top generals and people. Iran's swearing revenge, and the White House is continuing the operations of Bush. So we'll talk about government-sponsored terror with David Ray Griffin and all the attempted debunking that's been going on, the piece they had a month or so ago on one of the big TV channels, National Geographic. I've had Professor Stephen Jones on. I've had some of the other participants from the TV show on, like the founder of Architects and Engineers for 9/11 Truth, Richard Gage. He says they lied to him, swore it would be fair, swore they'd premiere and present their information, showed them a fake final cut that was nothing like what they actually saw. So we'll talk about that, too, with David Ray Griffin coming up here today. Just briefly, we are 25 hours and 50 minutes exactly, 25 hours and 50 minutes exactly on my mark. The atomic clock says 109, 57, 58, 59. On my mark right now, we are 25 hours, 50 minutes from the release of Fall of the Republic. We detail how Obama is controlled by the very same interests as Wall Street. We detail how he's being built up to be actually destroyed by these people, to be blamed for their entire agenda. We detail it all in Fall of the Republic. That's why I'm being demonized for the Obama deception right now by national media. Because this, when you watch this film, it's an indictment of the entire corrupt military-industrial complex. You can get the DVD right now at Infowars.com. They're now shipping out today. They're shipping them in mass right now. And it premieres at PrisonPlanet.tv at 3 p.m. Central tomorrow when the show ends. Two other sponsors I want to tell you about for the balance of the hour. David Ray Griffin is our guest. One of the sponsors I want to tell you about is Front Sight Firearms Training. It's family fun. The premier firearms training institute in the country. No drill instructor, no tough guy attitude. How to properly use a handgun, a rifle, a shotgun. They have two-day courses, four-day courses, five-day courses. They also have a lot of free online stuff at frontsight.com, F-R-O-N-T-S-I-G-H-T.com. And they've got a deal where you get a 30-plus state concealed weapons permit, a free Springfield Armory XT pistol in the caliber of your choice when you sign up for the five-day firearms training course that is extremely inexpensive. Long before I even knew what Front Sight was, like 10 years ago, 8, 9 years ago, everybody I knew, police, military, locals, all went there. This is above military and law enforcement level training. A lot of Marines and people go into theater, go there to get tuned up on their snipering. FrontSight.com, ladies and gentlemen, FrontSight.com. Check out the free deal or get on their free mailing list there at FrontSight.com. Okay, let's go ahead now and go to David Ray Griffin. He has a long bio, but he's kind of one of the omnibudsmen or the omnibudsman of the 9/11 truth movement. He just devastates the disinformation that the debunkers keep putting out, the lies, the distortions, how they keep changing their story. And there's so much to talk about. We've got this former prime minister coming out and saying he got a warning 10 minutes before, Danish prime minister, you know, that the towers were going to fall. That ties into Giuliani. We've got the debunking going on. We've got so many things that are happening. But David Ray Griffin, first off, great to have you here. And what do you think is most important today that you would like to cover first?
Well, of course, I have my new book on World Trade Center 7. And in my mind, and in that of many other people who've read it, it provides the most convincing evidence yet that the official story about the World Trade Center is false, and not simply false, but that they've just told lie upon lie. And in my book, I deal with the question of scientific fraud. which is a technical term put out by the National Science Foundation and others, that involves omission of data, falsification of data, and fabrication of data. And they do all of these, and they do them very blatantly and obviously.
So the NIST and report, so, all of it, is basically like Piltdown Man, really the jaw of a pig, not the missing link.
Yeah, I mean, they even contradict what they had put out in previous reports before they came up with their new theory. And so you can see they're lying. And for a lot of people whose eyes glaze over when you talk about steel temperatures and what fire can do to steel and what you need for a straight down symmetrical collapse, when they see that people are just lying, for many people that's the most convincing thing.
I want to go over that, but first let's get into some other issues, because this is key. The book is key. The consortium, the consolidation of the really vetted, hardcore data that you've put together in this book, and we, again, respect you as one of the foremost bona fide researchers, David Ray Griffin. You were, though, in the National Geographic hit piece. Give us your take on how that was shot, guarantees that were made. Do you agree with Jones, Professor Jones, and architect and engineer, others who are speaking out? Richard Gage. And what do you think of them shooting a missile into a chicken coop and saying that's the Pentagon? I mean, it was almost like this was made to be a joke, but go ahead.
Well, yes, I agree with what Richard said, that they were very deceptive in the way they approached us. And, you know, we've done this enough. We know to be cautious and to take these things with a grain of salt. But still, the level of, you know, duplicity here was really extreme. And then, as you say, these experiments they performed, and part of the duplicity was that they scheduled this interview with us where we were watching what was supposedly the virtually final cut while they were filming us, and they didn't tell us ahead of time that the crux of their argument against us was going to be the scientific experiment, and they scheduled at a time that Stephen Jones could not be there. Now, in fairness to them, they did originally hope he was going to be there, but he suggested they bring in Kevin Ryan instead, and even though they first contacted Kevin and he was willing to come, they did not bring him. So we didn't have a single scientist sitting around there.
Let's put this in layman's terms, though, okay, because I know you're being technical. They said, we want to show you basically the final cut. They get you in a room, you're there to see it, and they go, what do you think of this experiment? We're going to shoot a missile into a plywood box.
Yeah, and all three experiments, you know, for National Geographic, which really has earned a good reputation over the years with its quality magazine, they should be just horribly embarrassed by this, because what they presented as scientific experiments were just totally laughable. The other one that is even more outrageous was the thermite experiment. First of all, we had all stressed, Stephen Jones had particularly stressed, the difference between ordinary thermite, which is an incendiary, and nanothermite, which is a high explosive. And the argument has been that it was basically nanothermite with maybe some help from ordinary thermite and thermate, which has sulfur added, was used to bring the building down. Well, the guy said, well, you know, I couldn't get any nanothermite. An ordinary person can't get that. So we had to use what we had. So what he did is took a bag of ordinary thermite, put it up next to a steel column, didn't even make it into a shaped charge. Now, you know, if you take thermite and turn it into a shaped charge, it will cause some real damage to a piece of steel, but not just a sack of thermite that you set on fire. And then he said, there's proof that nanothermite could have not brought down the World Trade Center.
But well, David Ray Griffin, it's worse than that. I have seen Dr. Jones and others' thermite experiments with a cup of it on an engine block. Regular thermite burns right through. This stuff didn't even sparkle like sparklers. It really looks staged. And then they say on the show they couldn't even prove there's such a thing as explosive thermite, despite the fact there are scores of patents. NASA uses it on rocket decouplers. A bunch of NIST scientists are top explosive thermite experts. To just deny that there's even such a thing when it's at least 30 years old, I mean, I couldn't believe how ridiculous this show was.
Yeah, and here they were. They were coming up on the anniversary of 9/11, and I think they took the people who had become most visible, myself and Dylan Avery and Richard Gage and Stephen Jones, and the attempt was to discredit us with this, and what they ended up doing was simply discrediting themselves and discrediting National Geographic, because even ordinary citizens who have no understanding of scientific method and so on.